Hello everyone, in this section I will be explaining bandwidth utilization, multiplexing and spread spectrum. So what is the meaning of multiplexing? Whenever the bandwidth of a medium linking two devices is greater than the bandwidth needs of those two devices, at that instant the link can be shared. Multiplexing is a set of techniques that allows the simultaneous transmission of multiple signals across a single data link. So in the case of bandwidth utilization, the bandwidth utilization is a wise use of available bandwidth to achieve specific goals. Efficiency can be achieved by multiplexing, that is sharing of the bandwidth between multiple users. So in the case of multiplexing, either we can adopt frequency division multiplexing, wavelength division multiplexing, or synchronous time division multiplexing and statistical time division multiplexing to perform the multiplexing process. So in the frequency division multiplexing, so which is an analog technique that can be applied when the bandwidth of a link is greater than the combined bandwidths of the signal to be transmitted. In FDM, signals generated by each sending device modulates different carrier frequencies. These modulated signals are then combined into a single composite signal that can be transported by the link. Carrier frequencies are then separated by sufficient bandwidth to accommodate the modulated signal. So these bandwidth ranges are channels through which the various signal travels. Channels can be separated by strips of unused bandwidth, and that is called as guard bands. So in the given diagram, we can observe that the transmission path is divided into three parts, like channel 1, channel 2 and channel 3. So we consider FDM to be an analog multiplexing technique. However, this does not mean that FDM cannot be used to combine sources sending digital signal. A signal can be converted to an analog, and later we can adopt FDM technique. So here in the categories of multiplexing process, the given signal may be either analog or digital. For analog signal, we can adopt frequency division multiplexing and wavelength division multiplexing. The given signal is digital, so we can adopt time division multiplexing. FDM is an analog multiplexing technique that combines analog signals, and it uses the concepts of modulation. In the given diagram, we can observe that each source generates a signal of similar frequency range. Inside the multiplexer, these similar signals modulated different carrier signals, signal frequencies like F1, F2 and F3. The resulting modulated signals are then combined into a single composite signal that is sent out over a media link that has enough bandwidth to accommodate it. Similarly, after multiplexing, at the receiver end, we can demultiplex the signal. So that is FDM demultiplexing process. The demultiplexer uses a series of filters to decompose the multiplex signal into its constituent component signal. The individual signals are then passed to a demodulator that separates them from their carrier and passes them to the output lines. So this is just example for FDM concept. We are having five channels in the given problem, where we are having five channels and each with bandwidth of 5 kilohertz. And since we are having five channels, the maximum number of guard bands required are 4. So therefore, this means that the required bandwidth is 5 into the given bandwidth, that is 100 kilohertz, plus 4 into 10 kilohertz. The total bandwidth will be at least 540 kilohertz. So this is the representation of that problem. So next comes the analog hierarchy. So in the analog hierarchy, what we are doing is, initially we considered simple 12 voice channels. those voice channels are like the telephone channels, and each telephone frequency is around 4 kilohertz. So in order to frame a single group, we need to have 12 voice channels and 12 voice channels. So 12 into 4, that is 48 kilohertz. The group frequency is around 48 kilohertz. Similarly, in order to construct a supergroup, we need to have 60 voice channels or 5 groups. So each supergroup consisting of frequency will be around 60 voice channels with the frequency of 240 kilohertz. Similarly, we can construct a master group as well as jumbo group with 600 voice channels and 3600 voice channels. So next comes the wavelength division multiplexing. So wavelength division multiplexing, in simple we can call it as WDM, is designed to use the high data rate capability of fiber optic cable. The optical fiber data rate is higher than the data rate of metallic transmission cable. But using a fiber optic cable for a single line wastes the available bandwidth. So that we can allow, or we can use multiplexing concept, which allows us to combine several lines into one. So here we can observe that we are having three different wavelengths, that is W1, W2 and W3. We can combine those wavelengths into sum of W1 plus W2 plus W3 in the link as well as at the demultiplexer side. Once again, we can get back our wavelengths, that is W1, W2 and W3. WDM is an analog multiplexing technique to combine optical signals. So next comes the time division multiplexing. The time division multiplexing is a digital process that allows several connections to share the high bandwidth of the link. Instead of sharing a portion of the bandwidth as a FDM, the time can be shared. So note that in the given diagram, we are concerned with only multiplexing, not switching. This means that all the data in a message from source 1 always go to one specific destination. It may be either 1, 2, 3 or 4. The delivery is fixed and unvarying, unlike switching. We also need to remember that TDM is in principle a digital multiplexing technique. Digital data from different sources are combined into one time-shared link. So TDM is a digital multiplexing technique for combining several low-rate channels into one high-rate channel. TDM is a digital multiplexing technique for combining several low-rate digital channel into one high-rate channel. So in the case of TDM, or synchronous TDM, the TDM can be classified into synchronous TDM and statistical TDM. In the case of synchronous TDM, we need to concentrate on time slots as well as frames. So the data rate, the data flow of each input connection is divided into units, where each input occupies one input time slot. A unit can be one bit, one character, or one block of data. Each input unit becomes one output unit and occupies one output time slot. However, the duration of an output time slot is then n times shorter than the duration of the input time slot. In an input time slot is t seconds, the output time slot is t by n seconds, where n is the number of connections. In other words, a unit in an output connection has shorter duration. It travels faster. So in the diagram, we can observe that we can construct different frames, frame 1, frame 2, frame 3, by combining frame 1 can be constructed by combining A1, B1 and C1. Similarly, frame 2 can be constructed by combining C2, B2 and A2. Similarly, frame 3, C3, B3 and A3. In synchronous TDM, the data rate of the link is n times faster and the unit duration is n times shorter. Next concept is interleaving. So TDM can be visualized as two fast rotating switches. The TDM can be visualized as two fast rotating switches, one on the multiplexing side and the other on the demultiplexing side. The switches are synchronized and they rotate at the same speed, but in opposite direction. On the multiplexing side, as the switch opens in front of a connection, that connection has the opportunity to send a unit onto the path. This process is called as interleaving. Whenever the respective switch is open and that particular switch has the capacity to send the data on the transmission link. Similarly, at the receiver side, that is a multiplexer side, whenever the switch is open, that particular channel has the capacity to receive the data. Data rate management. So not like all the input links may have the same data rate. In some cases, the major problem with TDM is how to handle a disparity in the input data rate. In all our discussion so far, we assume that the data rates of all the input lines were the same. However, if the data rates are not the same, three strategies or combination of them can be used. So we call these three strategies as multi-level multiplexing, multi-slot allocation, and pulse stuffing. So in the case of multi-level multiplexing, used when the data rate of the input links are multiples of each other. Similarly, the multi-slot allocation can be used when there is a GCD between the data rates. The higher bit rate channels are allocated more slots per frame, and the output frame rate is a multiple of each input link. So the last method, in order to maintain the data rate, that is pulse stuffing, used when there is no GCD between the link. The slowest speed link will be brought up to the speed of the other links by bit insertion or padding. So this is multi-level multiplexing. So multiple, more than one level multiplexing. So initially 20 kilobits per second and 20 kilobits per second are multiplexed to get 40 kilobits per second. And after that 40, we are having four different channels with input data rate as 40 kilobits per second. And that can be multiplexed to get 160 kilobits per second. So multi-slot allocation or multi-slot multiplexing. So for one channel, we'll allocate two slots on the frame. So this 50 is divided into 25 and 25. And after that, we can maintain the uniform data rate as 25 kilobits per second with all input data rates. But for this particular channel one, we allocated more than one slot. The input with 50 kilohertz data rate has two slots in each frame. So the last method is pulse stuffing. So here we can observe that we are having three different input data rates with 50, 50 and 46 kilobits per second. So these two are uniform data rates, but it is 46 kilobits per second. In order to maintain the data rate as uniform, so we can go for pulse stuffing, that is additional zeros can be added to this particular input. So around 4 kilobits per second data will be zeros will be added to get the actual 50 kilobits per second as data rate. After that, we can combine or we can multiplex to get the output data rate as 150 kilobits per second.